Good morning. I have a little bit of a cold today, so sorry if I sound stuffy. Today is June 8th, 2020, and it's freezing. At least it's freezing here. It's freezing in Utah today. Gotta love the weather here. I love it actually because it's never boring, it's never dull. So today we are going to talk about vulnerability as an influencer and what that does for your power to influence people. And we're also going to talk about how to do it right and how to do it wrong. There's definitely a wrong way to be vulnerable. So before we get started, I'm going to draw a card for the group. And if anybody is on and wants to see a card just specifically for them, let me know. Oh man, I'm sorry I sound so scratchy today. I'm gonna open those on my phone too because sometimes I don't see comments on here when I do see them on here, so I'm just gonna make sure I open this on my phone too. Kim says it's 79 degrees with a high of 90. I am so sorry. It is super, super, super cold here. I actually dreamed that I woke up to snow because it was that cold. And it's been raining for 2 days. And yesterday it was 56. So it was a little chilly. Oh, my video is not loading on my phone. Okay, well, hopefully I'll see your messages. I saw Kim's message. All right, so I'm going to draw a card. If you don't know what I'm talking about when I said draw a card, I have designed, oh, and there's a poster for it that way. Manifesting deck. So I designed a manifesting deck based on 2 years of helping people manifest what they want and writing custom affirmations. And I took the ones that people need the most and I made a deck of cards out of them. So on the top, there is an affirmation that you say out loud. And then on the bottom half is an action step that you do that supports the affirmation. So that is what the card is about if you don't know what I'm talking about. Hi, Lynn. That's my husband. He's in his office in the same house working. Our offices are on opposite ends of the house, so we don't see each other very much when he works from home. All right, so I'm going to draw a card for the group. Setting my intention. This is a perfect card for you guys. I think we drew this one before. Today, I get to show up with love and understanding. This is especially good for when you tend to be easily triggered if you don't have enough sleep, or if you don't feel good, or you're running up against a deadline or something. This is a really good card for you. So today, hi, honey.
Hi, I'm gonna draw a card.
Oh, fun. So today I get to show up with love and understanding. All right, babe. Are you ready? Oops. Do you want to shuffle it for yourself?
I'd like to just draw one out of the middle.
Okay. For you?
Yes.
Not for the group? Are you going to
It
share
can
it?
be with anyone, for anyone that it resonates with,
All right, share
so
yours.
they can choose. I am full of money-making ideas, and I act on them confidently. You want to say it three times?
Oh yeah. So I forget to tell people. Say it once in a normal voice and then yell it and then whisper it because your subconscious pays more attention when you do different voices.
I said it pretty boldly the first time, but I'll
You
say it again.
did.
I am full of money-making ideas, and I act on them confidently.
Yeah, baby. Go for it.
All right, and my assignment is sit down and come up with 50 ways you can make at least $20. Choose one and do it.
That's a fun one.
Okay, I'm going to borrow this so I don't forget to do
And
it.
you can change that amount if you want, because 20 is pretty easy for you.
Okay. All right. Thanks. I just wanted to draw a card.
Thanks. Oh, he's so cute. All right. So if you're doing the card I pulled, today I get to show up with love and understanding. The action step is, imagine this is your last day on Earth. How would you interact with your loved ones? Interact that way with them today. Like you really love them. And I know you do. Just some days we get a little triggered. We get a little tired and cranky. And we don't always show up with unconditional love when we're feeling cranky. So there's your card for the day from me. And you got one from Lynn too. All right. So today we're going to, and if anybody else wants a card, just put it in the chat and I'll get you one. So today we're going to talk about vulnerability. Because if you want to manifest more influence in your life, so that you get more clients and more business and make more money, which I'm pretty sure all of you do, then part of that is that you need to be a real person. You need to be relatable and you need to, Christine, you need to show people that you are human and that they can get to where you are now. Because you used to be where they are now. So they've got to see that you have struggled on your path. And so they might be here on that same path as you, and you're up here. And when you show your vulnerable side, they can see that, oh, she struggled with that too. Oh my gosh, if she can overcome that, I can overcome that. So being vulnerable is super important as an influencer. Otherwise, you're gonna seem cold and impersonal and unrelatable, and people won't be drawn to you. In fact, they might even be annoyed by you and think that you're stuck on yourself or something. Okay, so being vulnerable. How many of you have read anything by Brené Brown? Or watched any of her TED Talks? I love Brené Brown. She is my spirit animal. I always say that. Whenever anybody asks me what's my spirit animal, I always say Brené Brown. Because I love her so much. So raise your hand or give me a thumbs up or a happy face or whatever if you have read or watched Brené Brown ever. Because she talks a lot about vulnerability. Also other things like shame. She's really awesome. I love her. Hello, Luana. Good to see you. Christine loves her too. Yeah, she's amazing. If you haven't, Lynn has watched Brené Brown. Awesome. If you haven't, I really suggest you start with her TED Talk and then move on from there because her TED Talk is amazing. So let's talk about being vulnerable and how to do it right and how to do it wrong, because there's definitely a wrong way to do it. Okay, so here are some wrong ways to be vulnerable. We'll start with the low and we'll go up to the high. When you make a big, long, vulnerable post about a trial you've had, or are having, here are some things to not do when posting that. You need to post a big, long, vulnerable story occasionally. If you do it every week, you're gonna look crazy. And in fact, even if you do it every month, you're gonna look a little crazy. So don't do it super often. I would say maybe twice a year is about a good time to do the really big, long, super vulnerable posts. So don't do those super often. Maybe once a quarter max. And if you are a person that does them all the time, you're going to look like a drama queen. And You're going to look like you're processing all your troubles on Facebook, and people are going to be wary of you, and they're going to think, she sure attracts a lot of drama into her life. Am I sure I want to follow her? So don't do it super often. Once a quarter max, better twice a year. Don't even think about doing it every month. And if you have my How to Be Obnoxiously Visible on Facebook ebook, I have a really good posting schedule in there. And if you don't have that, let me know and I'll give you the link to go buy it on my website. It's a really good ebook. Teaches you how to be obnoxiously visible, but in a good way that attracts your ideal clients. You're not really obnoxious. You'll feel like it, but you're not looking like it. Another thing not to do when you are making a vulnerable post, don't do it while you are still struggling with it and are feeling hopeless. If you feel like it's something that you are just, you don't know when you're going to figure it out. You don't know when you're going to get over it. You don't know when you're going to get through it. Don't post about it yet. You can make little posts about it occasionally. Like I would do, if I were doing something I were actually struggling with, I would ask a question. So I'd be like, is anybody struggling with whatever? And then the thing you're struggling with. And then you can open up a conversation without telling the whole world, oh my gosh, I'm a puddle on the floor right now. Because I always hear this, you need to speak from your scars, not from your wounds. Have you guys heard that before? Speak from your scars, not from your wounds. So, oh, hi, Kat. Hi, Sherry. Welcome. Sorry, I've got a cold today, so I sound a little weird. Sorry about that. But I've got my breathe diffusing in my diffuser, and I keep dabbing it on my lips so I can open up my sinuses. So make sure, I love that phrase, speak from your wounds. No, speak from your scars, not your wounds. So if it's still a big issue with you that you're super sensitive about and you're in a lot of pain, don't speak about it yet. Wait until you've got a handle on it. Because if you show that you're still a mess with it, people are going to be like, oh no, I'm struggling with this too, and she can't handle it either. I should just give up. So make sure you have gotten through it far enough that you can give good advice or good insight on dealing with it and resolving it. So speak from your scars, not your wounds. Hi, Shauna. Let me see. What was the other? Sorry, I need to blow my nose. The other thing was, when you're doing a vulnerable post, is don't throw people under the bus. And if you, I never heard that phrase until about 15 years ago. Maybe it's only that old, but that's when I first heard it. And I was like, what does that mean? But it means don't tell your story in a way that you're blaming somebody in your life, especially by name. Don't use their name, please. You can allude to someone in a general way that does not identify them. But when you're telling your vulnerable story, you need to make it about you, your choices, your healing, your journey, without saying, well, my so-and-so did this to me and it totally screwed me up in this way and how dare they and things like that. It's not a blame game. Don't throw them under the bus. Talk about your side of it and how you dealt with your feelings and how you overcame your own issues. Okay, so don't throw people under the bus. So how do you do a good vulnerability post? How do you show up in the right way being vulnerable on Facebook? So of course, again, speak from your scars, not your wounds. When you have a trial that you are going through, take note of what helped you along your way. Because if you are going to teach others how to get through the same trial you're going through, you're going to want to remember what you did to get through it. Because a lot of times we forget. When our emotions are high and things are dramatic and we're upset, we can forget the little things that helped us. So when you're going through something hard, take note of what helped you get through it so that you can share that with other people when you're teaching it or when you're doing your vulnerable post on Facebook about it. So you guys, probably a lot of you have seen my office thing, my office issue that I dealt with last week. And I have been struggling with cleaning my office for years. And I just felt completely overwhelmed by all the stuff I had in here. If you look at the top of my desk, now just has cute things on it. It used to be piled to the ceiling. Like, I couldn't reach the top of the piles. If I wanted something from the top of the pile, I had to grab it at the bottom and try to pull it down without everything falling. So I didn't want to throw anything away. I didn't know where to put anything. It was completely disorganized. So everything like for events was all mixed in with my office supplies and my notebooks from things. And oh gosh, it was a mess. And I could never find anything. And so I'd come into my office and I'd work and I would just be surrounded by clutter energy. And it was really, really, it really impeded my ability to work. And so finally last weekend, not this weekend, but the one before, I spent 3 days, 12 hours a day cleaning this office. And I posted pictures of it. And I was really embarrassed to show the before picture. And I thought, okay, I'm an influencer. I'm helping people along the same journey I'm on. I've got to show the before picture so they get it. So if their office looks like that, they can relate and they can say, oh, whoa, that's worse than mine. And she got it clean. Oh my gosh, if she can do it, I can do it. So I had to post my before picture. And then I also posted my during picture, which was way worse because it was just boxes piled everywhere because I had to go through every single box in my office. And what you probably didn't realize, I couldn't even get my legs under my desk. Like, I had to sit back here because my legs wouldn't fit because there were boxes everywhere. So I had to go through every box, every bin. I threw away so much stuff. Oh my gosh. Sarah, you're decluttering your desk right now. That's awesome. Oh, thank you, Sherry. That purple chair is so cute, right? I'm still debating. I read the reviews and I'm not positive it's the right chair for me. Some people said it's like, it's so short up to the ground that it's made for kids. So I'm not sure I'm going to get that one, but I'm going to keep looking and find the perfect purple chair. I might get that one because I'm short. I'm not sure. But thank you. But I mean, how many people did I inspire and give hope to by showing them my journey, by being vulnerable and showing them the disaster that was my office before I did it? And now look how cute it is. I have my sign up and I made that cute little desk back there with all my glitter fabric that I take to my events. So whenever I go to events, I have a table where I sell my cards and I put all that pretty sparkly fabric on it. So I love it now. And I think it's inspired a lot of people. See, Nina, it inspired her. And I know it inspired my friend Jennifer, who cleaned her office. And she was having a hard time working in her office too, because it just didn't feel good. And then after she saw me do mine, she went and did hers, and now she loves her office. So being vulnerable is so good for helping others when you do it right. It's so good to show other people that if you can get through it, they can get through it. So I highly encourage you guys, when you are struggling with something, oh, that's beautiful. Janelle, I love that. Oh, that's so pretty. When you're going through something, first, take notes of what you did to get through it. Second, speak from your scars, not your wounds. Talk about it when you've healed enough from it that you're not a puddle when you talk about it. And do it before and after everything's, before and after photos, whatever you need to do to show people that you really did it. You really were able to accomplish this. And if you can do it, they can do it. So being vulnerable is very inspirational. And it is really helpful to the people that are following you and that are watching you online. Jennifer, yeah, oh, good, you're going to do shelves today. That's awesome. Janelle, you're right. I don't have room for an entire chaise lounge, but it would be pretty awesome to have that in here. I just don't know where I'd put it. My office isn't that big. I have my closet there, so I can't put it there. And my printer's right next to me. And then there's a wall. So I don't think that would work. Dang it. I love it, though. Good suggestion. So let me ask if anybody has any questions about being vulnerable on Facebook. If you have any questions, put them in the comments. And how do you feel being vulnerable? I should give the backstory to that comment. So Janelle is campaigning for us to move to Eagle Mountain. And we went to dinner at her house yesterday and we spent probably 2 hours in her car, her family and my family, driving around, being shown the whole town and all the awesomeness about it. And so we are moving to Eagle Mountain. She convinced us. So, yeah, we're going to start getting our house packed up. We're going to move to Eagle Mountain before this year's over. I'm pretty excited. And yes, I will have room for that purple couch when we move. That's true. Cindy, sharing your struggles was that a question? Or is that the answer to my question? I'm not sure what you mean exactly there. So when we, you know, everybody has struggles. Everybody does. And sharing them is really good when you are giving your techniques for getting through them and things that worked for you. So it can be really good. Wow, what, Luana, that Janelle sold us on Eagle Mountain. She's a really good salesman. She totally convinced us. That was awesome. Plus, you guys have to get this game called Slapsy. It's hilarious. Is that what I mean? I'm not sure. I've already forgotten what I asked. What did I say? What are your struggles with being vulnerable? What issues do you have when you are trying to be vulnerable? What stops you from being vulnerable on Facebook is what I mean. Kim says, sometimes people can believe that what you post on Facebook is 100% real, which is, in my case, normally positive, but I share my vulnerability a few times during the year to be seen as human. However, I did start a podcast so I can actually use my struggles to help others. Yeah, you guys, Kim's awesome. Her posts are always like fun and uplifting, and she is super positive on Facebook, and I love that. And when people take it Some people take it as a reason to get mad at her or a reason to get triggered. And that's just so sad. But yes, she has a podcast now, so she can say what she wants on her podcast because people can't get on and post mean comments about it. Oh, Cindy, being embarrassed. Okay, that's good. Being embarrassed, that's a thing. I mean, you've got to get to the point where you ask yourself, is it more important that I help people or is it more important that I look like I have it all together all the time? So if it's more important to you to look like you always have things together, then you're not going to be able to influence as many people. Because if people don't ever know that you have struggled with anything, they're not going to connect with you. So you'll get a deeper connection with people when you learn to let go of embarrassment, let go of what other people think about you, and focus on loving everybody. Focus on loving and helping the people that follow you on social media. And don't worry about what they're judging you for. And you know what? Most of the time, people are too worried about themselves to be judging you. So that's a really good thing to remember. Usually the judgment comes from your own mind, judging yourself, and assuming that everyone else is judging you too. Most of the time, that is not the case. Luana, going from the hard things to the things that lead to change without losing viewers. Yeah. If you wait till you're through the hard thing, then you can do it without being negative. If you wait till you're through the hard thing and then post about it, then share your struggles and how you got through it, then it won't be negative. If that's what is causing you to lose viewers, that's what I would suggest. Wait till you're all the way through it. Hi, Carol. All right, Sarah says, when I share something vulnerable, I often do it in a motivational way, talking about how we can overcome, etc. But I feel that most of the reactions I get from people are like, I'm so sorry, which is not what I was trying to do. I was trying to motivate, not to make people feel bad for me. Does that make sense? That totally makes sense. Yes. And you know what? That's actually pretty common. I've seen people do that a lot, where they take the meaning wrong and they're like, oh, you poor thing, I'm so sorry. When obviously you're through it now and you're just trying to share your struggle to help others, you just got to let go of that. Let go of it. Let them feel sorry. It's because they love you and it's okay that they misunderstood. Maybe your posts need to be a little more clear that you are that you're not suffering. Maybe check your post to see if it sounds like if there's any words you've used or anything that makes it sound like you're still suffering. Maybe go back and analyze those posts and see if there's anything you might need to tweak when you do it again. Oh, Luana, that's what you're talking about too. Oh, yeah. Yeah, if you guys, you know what? If you want to post me, if you want to tag me in one of those posts where that's happened, I could go check your wording and see if I have any suggestions if you like. I would go do that if you are interested in that. So tag me in one of those posts that make you feel like that, where people feel bad for you. And I'll see if I can find any tweaks to suggest for you. Because it's really important to be vulnerable. It is a thing very worth getting over in order to get it right so that you can have more influence. Carol, how do you get people not to comment on posts that way? I think it's all in the wording. When people feel like you're suffering, they want to help you. They want to give you sympathy. So I think it's a matter of wording. Yeah, it is very relatable, Sarah. I see it a lot. Oh, you're welcome, Luana. So yeah, tag me and I'll go look if you want. Oh, it's 10:01. We got to go. All right. So if you're in my advanced manifesting group, I will see you in the Zoom right now. Everybody have an awesome day. Oh, and don't forget, this Friday and Saturday is Manifesting Influence. It's a 2-day event on Zoom to help you grow your influence. And we're going to go through so many awesome things, like ideal client, how to post on Facebook, how to get clients on Facebook, how to turn Facebook into a sales funnel and make a lot of money on Facebook. It's going to be awesome. So don't forget to register for that. It's called Manifesting Influence, and I'll post the event again. But that is this week, so it's going to be too late to get tickets pretty soon. Let's see. Kim says, I think vulnerability and whining on Facebook are two different things. You just have to know the difference. That's true. Thank you, Sarah. I hope I do too. I hope that I am completely well tomorrow. I'm going to manifest that. All right, you guys are awesome. I will see you all next time. Have a great day and stay warm if you're in Utah because it's freezing. All right, I'll see you guys. Bye.